Hello and welcome to Taxi Tutorials. Today we are going to learn about constructors in JavaScript. This is the very first tutorial in a much larger series on object-oriented JavaScript. A lot of you have asked me questions on prototype, inheritance, mixins. A lot of you ask me, when are you going to release the tutorials on classes? So I thought, instead of just releasing tutorial on classes, I should create this comprehensive series that explain you from the beginning to end. And I did lots of research on it and created this wonderful tutorial series. And I'll try to release maybe once a week or twice a week so that you can get your learning going. And in order to understand overall object-oriented JavaScript, I think constructor is the best place to start because that's how you create objects. The ultimate objective of object-oriented programming is to create objects with ease. In programming languages like Java, you have classes, and then classes have constructors, which basically helps you set the initial property of the object you create. But in JavaScript, you can create constructor directly. Initially, they didn't have classes, so they had just constructor. Even though they have introduced the class keyword, inside they're doing the same thing. So that is why I wanted to start with constructors. So understanding constructor would help you understand classes. Now you can create constructor using just regular functions. And there are special way to do it. So let's look at the difference between a regular function and a constructor. So here, in this example, I have a regular function, add, which takes two numbers, does some calculations, and returns the result. The job of a function usually is to do specific things, and it would always, not always return something. Sometimes it sets something to something, but usually it would return something. And you can call it simply by putting parentheses and, you know, passing arguments. Let's write a constructor now to see the difference. So let's say if I create a car constructor, I'm going to start with the name car, and it looks like a normal function. It will have color as a parameter. And inside, instead of doing some calculation, I will set this dot color equal to color. Remember, I told you that the job of a constructor is to set the initial properties of the object that it creates. So here, actually, when I say this dot color, basically it's setting the property for the object that you will create from this constructor. Now, calling the constructor is a little different than a regular function. So I would say let red car, this is the object it creates, and you would say new keyword, and then call the car constructor, and I'll pass the color red. So this will basically create a red car by setting the color property red to it. So compared to the regular function, this has a new keyword in front of the constructor. Also, you'll notice that when I build a regular function, I'm just camel casing the name. But constructor, I would prefer to have a first letter capital so you can differentiate between a regular function and a constructor. It won't hurt if you don't do it, but it's a good practice so you can recognize it. All right, so let's look at this new object that we just created. So if I run this, I would see the object that I create here. It would basically say car, and then inside it would say color equal to red. Now if I expand this a little bit, I would see proto here. It's underscore underscore proto underscore underscore. Now it is very important to understand this concept because object-oriented JavaScript is all about prototype inheritance. And this right here is the most important thing to understand. What this is, it's a creator of this object. So think of underscore underscore proto underscore underscore is a creator of this red car. How did it create this creator? Well, we'll look at this in a detail, but when you call the constructor using the new keyword, it basically sets the property that you need to set inside the constructor. And then it would have a reference to its creator here. And if you expand this here, you would see the constructor as a part of the creator. So constructor is not the creator, but it's part of the creator. Now, let's say if I want to create a blue car, I can simply do this. I can say blue car equal to blue. And this two object, red car and a blue car, are going to be completely different. However, they would have the same reference to the constructor, which is this car constructor. Now, what if I don't use the new keyword? What would happen? So let's look at it, because a lot of people make this mistake and they pay the price. So let's say if I call this constructor without a new keyword, I would get undefined. And the reason I get undefined is when I call it without a new keyword, it looks at this as a regular function. And as you can see, there is nothing being returned here. So when there is nothing being returned, function returns undefined. That's why you are getting undefined. Okay, now what happened to the this.color? In this context, this really means the global object, which is window. So what it did is it added a new property to the global object, which is window. We can see it here. If I do window.color, run this, I would get red. So window does have a new property, which is red. Since I never intended to create it, it's kind of a problem because you don't want to create properties into global space. So to avoid that, there are two ways to do it. First, you can just simply use strict. When you do this, you won't be able to call a constructor without a new keyword. So let's say if I do this, it would give me an error saying cannot set a property color of undefined, which is good. However, it could be confusing. So if I want to have a write error. So what I can do here is inside the constructor, I can add a line here, an if statement. I can say if new.target, if it's not the new target, then you can throw called. So basically it checks if I call it new or not. And if the target is not new, then it knows that you haven't called it with new. And so we throw this error. So now if I run this, I would get that error, car must be called with new. In JavaScript, when you create properties using constructors, they are all public properties, which means you can directly access the property using dot. So you can say red car dot color. This should give you the color red. So if I run it, I would get red. JavaScript doesn't have a concept of private properties. However, you can create one using closures. And the way to do it is, so instead of this.color, what I would do is, I would have a setter and a getter. So I would say this.setColor equal to a function color argument, and it would have a inner variable called color, and it would set this color to the color. And similarly, you can have a getter. So I can say this.getColor equal to function, and since it's just returning a color. Now, since there is no this dot property name, car doesn't have that property. It just have a inner variable that is only can be accessed using these methods because of the closures. I have a tutorial on a closure if you want to look at it, if you don't know what closures are. So now when I create a red car, and if I just try to access red dot, car dot color, let's say underscore color, it would not give me that. It would say undefined. So I really have to call getCar.getColor, and now it would give me the color red. Now that we have the properties in the constructors, what about the methods? So the best way to set the methods for this object are not directly inside the constructor, just like we did this.color. Instead, you should use its prototype to set the property. So in next tutorial, we are going to learn how the prototype works. At the end of the tutorial, I'll provide a link so you can follow it. And please make sure that you bookmark the playlist or this tutorial so you can follow the entire series. And I hope you learned something from the tutorial. And if you did, please like, subscribe, and provide a constructive comment. Thank you.